Thank God for another day, beloved, as we continue to look into His Word and know some of the deceptive teachings of demons, that they will not deprive you of your blessings. In the last episode, I handled the demonic teaching concerning tithing. The whole idea about tithing has to do with my blessing. It has to do with blessing. And if God said, if you don't do it, it is a curse and you are robbing Him. But if I do it, it's a blessing. Then there's no big deal. What if you are wrong? I'll inherit God's curse. And He says, I'm robbing Him. If it's right, listen to the important analysis that I gave last time. We have a lot of benefits. So run away from every church, every so-called preacher who will be speaking against tithing. It will be demonic teaching, and he may not understand the ordinance of God. It has to do with tithe, blessing. Sorry. So understand that one as we go ahead. Learn more things about demons and their deceptive things. Today I want to handle another deceptive teaching. And that one has to do with once saved, forever saved. They are teaching things that will let some people feel comfortable and not do away with sin in their lives. So they say that for once God will save you and you are forever saved. What they intend to carry is that once I walk into church and I am saved by confessing and believing that Jesus is my Lord, I am forever saved. It doesn't matter what I do afterwards. That is what demons have led people to teach for the ignorant to understand. That it doesn't matter what you do, once you are saved for once. Once you are saved, you are always saved. It doesn't matter what you do afterwards. And I want you to understand that that teaching is demonic. It is very demonic. Why? It is telling you that once you come to God, and it saves you from sin, you can go back to it. I've dealt with this in my book. I've dealt with this question also in my book. So you can read it and get more information. But you have to understand that God, Apostle Paul, was admonishing the Christians of his day. So let's hear what he told them in 1 Corinthians chapter 10. He says, moreover, brethren, I do not want you to be unaware that all our fathers were under the cloud, all passed through the sea, all were baptized into Moses in the cloud and in the sea, all ate the same spiritual food, and all drank from the same spiritual drink, for they drank of that spiritual rock that followed them, and that rock was Christ. This is my point, verse 5. He says, but with most of them, God was not pleased, for their bodies were scattered in the wilderness. Verse 6, he was admonishing the Christians. He said, now these things became our examples to the intent that we should not lust after evil things as they lasted. What was Paul talking about? God saved the whole Israel from Egypt, and he used the parting of the Red Sea and Israel passing through as a way of baptism. So he saved Israel from Egypt. His point was that not all of them entered the promised land. Why? He said they were scattered on the wilderness because of some sins. So he says Christians should take a cue from that. Not all of them inherited the promised land. Why? Because of their sins. Their bodies were scattered because of their sins. So he says in verse 6 that it should be examples to us. What does he want to convey? What does Apostle Paul wants to convey? It means that he wants to tell us that if you are saved in Christ and afterwards you live in sin, God can reject you. You can be in trouble. You will not inherit the kingdom of heaven. If you want to enter the kingdom of heaven, then you stay clean after your redemption. Let me ask you a simple question. You were in the mud, and I took you out of the mud, brought you under the shower, and I poured water on you to make you clean, washed you clean. And you said, thank you for saving me from the mud. Could have been drowned, could have stayed dirty. Then we say, okay, you are welcome. Afterwards, then you say, because I brought you under the shower and I saved you, you can go back into the mud, stay and soil yourself again. And you still say you are still saved because of the one-time event that happened. No. Does it make sense to you? No. So if you say God saved you from sin and you go back to the same sin, where is the salvation? Where is it? And how do you say he saved you? So it is demonic teaching. Run away from such churches who are teaching these things. I've been saying that I love you. We have to teach things that will let people abandon sin. God is holy. My God is holy. Paul was using that, the salvation of Israel from Egypt, as an example. It is similar to what is happening today. If God saves you, it doesn't mean that you go back to sin and still say that God saved you. That means salvation is just by word of mouth. If you say it like that, it means salvation is just by word of mouth and not what you do afterwards. That is completely erroneous. So understand that one. The next thing they teach wrong is the grace of God. The first thing I've talked about today has to do with once saved, forever saved. It has to do with salvation. If God saves you and you play the fool, he can reject you. The next thing has to do with the grace of God. Demonic preachers are also teaching the grace of God in a way that is very, very disturbing. Very disturbing. From what they are teaching, no matter what you do, the grace covers you. You see, they say some of these things, that you can even escape God's judgment by his grace. There's no guarantee that you can go through the judgment. It will all happen by his grace. They say that. They say that the grace covers you in everything. They say that no matter what you do, you are still in the grace. You see, when they teach these things, it will never let a sinner leave his sins. That is why when some young people go to such churches and they hear such messages, they never stop fornicating. They continue to fornicate because they say the grace of God covers them no matter what they do. So this type of teaching have captivated a lot of students. A lot of students are following this type of teaching. But please be warned as a Christian. If you want to enter the kingdom of God, then please don't abuse the grace of God. By his grace, he offered us his salvation, his merciful hand, and we responded in faith and we came in. Now, if you stay in and you tell God that you can go and sin and come again because of the grace, it is wrong. Let's hear what Apostle Paul said in Romans chapter 6. Paul said, "What shall we say then? Shall we continue to sin that grace may abound?" He said, if you say God has grace, God is very gracious, then his question is, should we continue to sin and let grace abound? Verse 2 says, certainly not. Paul was saying, certainly not. You shouldn't continue to sin. What he means is that if God saved you by grace, abandon sin. You have to leave sin. So he says, how shall we who died to sin live any longer in it? How? You died to sin. If you died to something, you don't live to go back to it. You don't live to go back to it. So understand that demons have their preachers to teach things. The demons like preachers who flatter people. They like preachers like that. And they have captivated their minds, corrupted their minds. All the people who teach these things, listen to what they also talk about fornication. Listen to what they also talk about certain things that God forbids, homosexuality, lesbianism, and all those things. Listen to how they talk about it. You can stay in those churches and never stop sinning because they say it is the grace of God. God has enemies. And if God has enemies, you cannot tell God whose enemies are Satan-led demons. You see, all the demons are God's enemies. God saves you from them, brings you to his kingdom for you to have his nature of holiness and live for him. And you, the same person, you are telling him that I can go back to your enemies, take up their characters, live like them, and still come to you because you are gracious. You can't imagine. You are taking the grace of God into a disrespectful level. That is abuse. It's like a woman. Let me use a woman as an example. It's like a woman who is married to a man. Then the man says that, well, once we are married, I can go around with other women and I will always come back to you because you always take me back. You see, it doesn't work like that even in marriage. God says, if you marry and you defile the marriage bed, the other partner can leave you. That means the marriage covenant is broken. It's broken. In the same way, if God saves you and you go around back to the demonic life, imagine. Then you come back and say, no matter what I do, God is gracious. There are people who only know the other side of God. The same God who is gracious is also a consuming fire, if you don't know. So, people who teach these things don't understand. They make demons happy. But you as a Christian, you have to understand. It is also like a child who thinks he can do anything to soil the reputation of the family. And when he comes back and is still doing the same thing, the father should accept him. That is wrong. If you come back, you must stop what you are doing for them to disown you. That is what it means. So if you say you love God, stay with him. And if you go back and you are coming again, you regret for what you did, because demons have the nature of rebellion. They don't want to believe in God. So if the demonic operatives are teaching that you can go back to sin, oh, and then the grace of God will cover you, they are lying to you. It is a lie. Don't believe such teachings. It is a lie. Such teaching is a lie. It is just to keep you in sin, to keep you bound in iniquity, so that God will punish you one day. Please, run away from preachers who are looking for money and fame. They are looking for two things. And the third one is to captivate you for demons. Money and fame. And captivate you for demons. That's all. So they speak things that people want to hear. They tell things that will let you be happy. So that you will not stop sinning. So you have to understand. You have to understand. Paul told young Timothy. 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 19. Paul said, nevertheless, the solid foundation of God stands, having this seal, the Lord knows those who are his. And let everyone who names the name of Christ depart from iniquity. Simple. He was telling young Timothy that God knows those who are his. And God's foundation stands sure. So if you say you belong to God, then please depart from iniquity. If you flip it, it means if you say you belong to God, then live holy as he is. That is my point. That is why I'm gathering people, training them to live holy, to bring back the nature of God in this sinful world. Simple. Live holy, live holy, and let God be glorified in your life. That is why Paul was telling Timothy that we should not carry the grace of God outrageously in our lives. We should not grace abound by continuing to sin. Understand that God saved you and he doesn't want you to remain in sin. So these are the things they teach people. Hey, some of them are misbehaving, and when you ask them, why are you doing this as a Christian? And then they will tell you, oh, you know, the grace of God. And they will tell you, you know, I have the grace of God because of the grace. Why are you doing this? Oh, because of the grace. Why are you doing that? Because of the grace. If it's because of the grace, because of the grace, then God will not get angry when demons went against his word. When they went against his word, God became angry and drove them away from heaven. And they would never go back there. So if you say you are a Christian, abhor the teachings of demons. Abhor their nature of sin. God is holy. Live in holy and don't let those who are teaching the grace of God outrageously deceive you. That is demonic deception. It is demonic. It is meant to hold you captive. It is meant to prepare you for hell. God loves you, please. Be aware that God is holy. He doesn't like sin. Please, avoid these teachings and sit up as a man, as a woman who desires to enter the kingdom of heaven. I love you. I love you. I want us to enter the kingdom of heaven and live in eternity. Don't let the pleasures of this world keep you bound. Demons are liars and deceptive, and deceiving ones. Don't listen to their deceptive ways. I love you. Live holy and enter the kingdom of heaven. I will see you again next time as we learn more of demons and their deceptive ways. God bless you. I'll see you again. Bye-bye.
Thank you for watching this video. I really hope you have been enlightened. To hear more, you may subscribe to this channel and click the notification bell to see more videos. Pastor Kukudatsi has written a very informative book called How Demons Operate. Grab yourself a copy to know how they operate and know how to liberate yourself from demonic oppression. To stay in contact with us, you can reach us through these details. God bless you.